Operate. That is how the operators operate. They make you think that you need them while you don't need them. It is something that it has been in the books for the longest time because that is what has been happening. Anyway, that is the short story I was penning when you were calling me a fraud. Thank you. I didn't really get the question so well, but I would respond to the guy as we continue with the conversation. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that analogy of aristocrats and proletariats. We really don't need them. We really don't need them. Now, to Kijanjaruka, once we see through their BS, the game is over. I liked what 6000's, his analogy also, which is in line with the metaphor and historical connotations that Kenya has given, that we are the employers. They are our employees. There is nowhere in any office that the employer fears the employees. And that's why, as Mkenya was saying, we're going to have a conversation, a small meeting with our employer, Ruto. We are to impart a mandate. And that's why we have
to... Ruto is our employee.
Yes, he's our employee. We are the employer. We're going to have a small meeting with our employee. We gave them that mandate. We gave him that mandate. Tomorrow, that small meeting is happening. And we will have a performance review there. We will, but I think nimesikia fununu tunaenda kumfire. But anyway, it's a public secret. Don't share, don't say too loud. We don't want him to get disgruntled and start shooting everything in this country. But that meeting is going to happen. It's going to happen. I have to give the microphone to Yamal. Yamal, karibu kwenye space, comrade. Can you hear me, Yamal? Dr. Nimrod, I think you're ready to go.
Good afternoon, guys. Well, Kenya, my comrades. Mine is just to sum it up from since we started this journey. The thing is, you know what? What rule? Let me do the honest question. Mtu ashamu kuua na sete na watu wazima ama and the guys killing combatants anaua watoto anaua watoto. Sasa hebu niambie, wo legality or wo moral authority has he got to come and dictate to the Kenyan people that he can lead us? See, the moment that guy killed those kids na mpaka leo he's never come out and give it even a state address reference to the death of those kids. So ni mtu kwenda na ubidi kana lao kaona lao hapa kitu kitu basi zako ni kwa sababu kama mtu anaweza kama mtu anaweza anazoa watoto, sasa imagine sisi watu wazima, unaona. And this is another thing I wanted to rally about. I said, if you kuna jamaa mmoja amesoma vizuri sana hapa, this is a rally call for every Kenyan, mpaka watoto wa skuli. Everyone should come out. And let's see if we're going to shoot everyone. And this is what this is another thing I said earlier on. I said, the military should be aware that they took an oath. Police takes an oath to serve the government. The military takes an oath to protect the nation and its people. So we should have those two distinctions clearly marked. So everyone should know their responsibility. So this is a rally call to the guys in the barracks. Yeah? Don't let your brothers and sisters, don't let your kids get slaughtered by a tyrant who just is hell bent on just being on top. Because we gave him a job, he couldn't do it. We don't want him. Because if his government and is in charge, why were the police not out there arresting those goons? I'm just using this, Wally. That is a level of a tyrant you're dealing with. Like in the case of the owner, at a Tuamaka armored vehicles. Yet what do we have? It's just flags, a phone, and a bottle of water. That's what you're dealing with. So you got to make a stand. And this is what I wanted to say. I know there's some of us who will not come back tomorrow. Guys, remember, your name shall be written in history forever, man. And but after we have liberated our country, at Uhuru Park we should actually build a proper monument for each and everyone who have already lost their names and who might not even come back tomorrow or the day after. That should be a remembrance that we should never spill blood again just to fight to ask for good governance in this country. Because that's a travesty. It's a self-hate. What we're doing is killing ourselves just asking for what is right. And that's what people don't understand. We're spilling our own blood just for asking what is right. And that's the sad part of it. So please, those ones who will be coming with us tomorrow, please, remember, man, you gave it your all and we'll never forget you. The country will always be indebted in you. And those who will stay, we still have to fight on until we make it happen. And like I said, a monument has to be erected at Uhuru Park for everyone. For everyone. After everything, after the dust has settled, we're back in our own feet. We have to make a celebration, a national day for the people who have actually. And that's why you look at that photo, profile photo of mine. You know, people walk over there. Kuna demo moja aliongea jana, I think ni jana leo asubuhi. I said, these people walking over that tarmac. Na wewe boy, brain zake ziko kwa hapo. We cannot allow that. And we should never allow that. But never should we forget that. And that's why we're saying he has to go. Nane nane. Strong was he. Umoja ni nguvu. That's what is happening to you.
Thank you, Dr. Nimrod. Thank you so much for your powerful points. And give it to Yamal. Yamal. Mike Nyako. Yamal. 6,000 nipu. Chiki kama Yamal nakusikia.
Yamal, I can see your hand is raised. Can you hear the voice of the host? Yamal? I think it's only Yamal who can't hear or speak. But the rest, if you can hear the host...
What about Tom and Jerry?
Tom?
It's the second time I'm calling him. He's still dead.
Tom, are you there? Tom, can you hear me speak?
Dead mic. Lucy?
That's a dead mic.
Lucy?
Yes, I'm here. Hi.
Lucy?
Yes, I'm here. Hi. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak. I speak as a mother, as a Kenyan, as a business owner, and it appears for me that nothing seems to be working in the country. And I am so proud of all of the young people who have decided to say enough. I am 44 years old. I've been going to the streets from day one of Maandamano with my kids. My kids are Gen Zs. And I see the passion that they have to define their future. And it breaks my heart that there are children who have come to the streets and did not go back home to their mothers. That we have a president who is so insensitive that is sending police to shoot at children and then stand in front of the country and command that we listen to him and command that we be okay with everything that he is doing. My heart is broken for the children, for the mothers, for the young people who have seen their friends shot. I am deeply saddened and I pray that tomorrow all the children who are going to the streets to demand for the Kenya they want, the Kenya they deserve, will be safe. I will be there. And I pray that something changes because we cannot continue like this.
We cannot continue being led by a president who is so insensitive, and we have leaders who honestly don't care because they have enough. They are fine, they are sorted. I have a business, I've been running a business for 14 years. This year I had to lay off my employees. I work with people who have an average age of 28, 29. I am left with two people because of just how hard it is for businesses to thrive in the it's ridiculous. And I am praying over all of the people who are going to be on the streets tomorrow. I am so proud of you. I am so proud of you, and I uphold you. Whatever gods anyone you pray to, whatever God you pray to, whatever religion, I pray that you will be safe and that no mother will have to bury their child tomorrow or in the coming days, because I am all for occupying until this person goes home. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Lucy. Thank you for